Early on June the 11th, pro-government forces, supported by the Russian Aerospace Forces, repelled a militant attack coming from the US-held area of Al-Tanf in eastern Syria on the ancient city of Palmyra, according to the Russian military. Syrian troops reportedly detected a group of militants with motorcycles and vehicles equipped with machine guns near Tall Ghurab. Five militants were killed and a vehicle and a motorcycle were destroyed in the clashes, which erupted. The Russian military added that attempts by militants to carry out operations from the Al-Tanf area appear on a regular basis. On the same day, Major General Igor Konashenkov, a spokesman for the Defense Ministry, said that the US-backed Free Syrian Army and US Special Operations are preparing a serious provocation involving chemical warfare agents in the province of Deir Ezzor. The goal of the provocation is to create a pretext for a new missile strike on Syria's state facilities by the US-led coalition and to justify an attack by US-backed forces on Syrian army positions in the Euphrates Valley. Recently, the US has supplied the Kurdish-dominated Syrian Democratic Forces, SDF, with 250 trucks, including Hummer-armed vehicles, heavy weapons and pickups, the Russian state media says, citing an SDF source. According to the source, the ammunition and armoured vehicles are delivered overland from northern Iraq through the Semelke border control post and from there to the east of Deir Ezzor. At the same time, ISIS has continued its fierce attacks on government forces in the Homs Deir Ezzor desert, advancing in the Humaymah T2 Muazilah triangle. The advance was repelled by the SAA, but the situation in the area remains tense. The increased ISIS activity poses a security threat to the SAA-held area, especially if the US-led coalition finds the needed pretext to carry out strikes on government forces.